Right now, we are going to talk about restoration to forgiveness. And it's all part of yung buong theme ng renewal, revival. So we speak of restoration tonight. Tinitignan mo yung ating prayer meeting na yun kami. Kailangan na mag-restore na virus tayo. Kahit sa mga nyata, I was told that peace canceled all the activities. No? So, pero maganda yung sinabi ng isang police station, even these times of crisis, we don't pray in our churches. Not good. So, okay, so when we speak about restoration, brothers and sisters, first of all, yung word restoration comes out very strongly in one of the letters of St. Paul, in Galatians chapter 6, verse 10, that we need. Yung naman ng Galatians chapter 6, verse 10, sabi ni St. Paul, "Brethren, if a man is overtaken in any trespass, you who are spiritual, restore such a one in a spirit of gentleness, considering yourself, lest you also be tempted." So, part of the teaching of the Apostle Paul, sabi niya, isa sa mga mahalagang character ng spiritual development is being able to experience this particular gift of restoration. At hindi natin masyadong na-encounter kasi yung word na restoration. Kaya siguro, magandang pag-usapan natin. Unang-una, what do you mean by restoration? What do we mean by spiritual restoration? Gaya ng sinabi ni St. Paul sa letter niya sa mga taga-Galacia, we who are spiritual, we must lead others in an experience of restoration. Very close to restoration is the word reconciliation, but they are not the same. Ano na? How we plan. Pero hindi yun ang ibig sabihin ng restoration. When we look back into the story of the Bible, I think, first of all, the entire story of the Old Testament, doon na yung makikita yung general picture na restoration, yung kwento ng Old Testament. Bakit? Makikita po natin sa Old Testament yung naging tragedy ng Israel. That Israel, despite the fact na favored siya ni God, despite the fact that they were a covenanted people, they many times failed God in their covenant. Bumagsak sila. In fact, when you look at the Old Testament, God allowed the Israelites to experience two periods of purification. Yung una, nagganap siyempre sa Egypt, 420 years of slavery. Yung isa, nagganap sa Babylon, 70 years of captivity in Babylon. But in both cases, the Israelites were greatly reduced. Reduced, not so much in number. Maybe we are reduced in number because of the corona. But reduced in terms of their dignity as a nation. Nawala yung temple, nawala yung Ark of the Covenant, nawala yung legitimate dominion ng mga hari, no? Kasi inherited yung hari, no? By blood. Nawala din yung legitimate line ng mga hari. They had to reconstruct the family of the priests. So that is how Babylon reduced Israel. So talagang nasira sila. Kaya nga, during the time of Babylon, the Israelites clung to the one and only treasure that they had left. And that is Scriptures. So yun yung time na talaga pinursige nila na isugat lahat ng libro ng Old Testament. Because that was all that was left. No temple, no priest, no prophet, no kings. So the entire culture of Israel was wiped out. So except the oral tradition. Kaya mula doon sinulat nila yung scriptures. And yet, you know, after all of that, God implemented a period of restoration for Israel. And it started in the time of Nehemiah. Nehemiah, Ezra, yung dalawang characters in the Old Testament, they were actually the great witness of the restoration. Kung paano hindi lang pinabalik ng Diyos ang mga Israelites to the land of promise, kung hindi God provided, out of the blues, God provided financing and leadership para sa ganon maitayo ulit yung walls of Jerusalem, maitayo ulit yung temple na nasira. So, the entire Old Testament is actually therefore, for me, the greatest example of restoration. In a smaller scale, restoration is also the storyline of David. Alam na lang yun yung buhay ni David, di ba? Kung paano nagsimula siya na isang simple pastor, shepherd, who happens also to be a musician by hobby. And he was not considered to be a leading candidate to be king. In fact, his own father, Jesse, did not include David among his sons na pagbibilingan ng prophet Samuel. But out of that particular lonely origin, David was chosen. He became the greatest king of Israel, but after that, he also had his own fall. And I remember the words of the philosopher Aristotle. Sabi ni Aristotle, The fall of the greatest is always the worst. And the sabi ni Aristotle. And David was like that. So, because of his fall, he had a rebellion of his son, Absalom. His son Absalom died, murdered by his own general. He had to evacuate Jerusalem. Maraming bagay ang nangyari kay David dahil po sa kanyang naging maling mga ginawa. He had to reap the harvest of his mistakes. Okay. Not that God was really punishing him, but you know, in this world, there is such a thing as cause and effect. Diba? Cause and effect. Kung ginawa mo ito, natural, may mangyayari. May natural cause. Gaya nito, ating nagagalang may spirit, di ba? Eh, paano kung may Diyos, bakit hinahayaan? Bakit hinahayaan? I always tell people, yes, nothing in this world happens without God knowing it. Lahat ng bagay sa mundo nagaganap, alam ng Diyos. Pero bakit nagaganap? Pwedeng number one, talagang kalooban ng Diyos, lahat ng Diyos. Pero pwede rin naman number two, hindi kalooban ng Diyos. Ngunit, inayahan for a good cause. Yeah. Inayahan. So, itong coronavirus, kalooban ba ng Diyos to? Malay ko. Pero alam niya, at the minimum, kung hindi man niya kalooban, inayahan niya. Kayo na ang mag-isip kung bakit niya inayahan. Baka magpahiral pa ako. Meron kami sa bahay ng bayan. Kaya nag-pull down siya ng ganyang Facebook account. Kasi, binutakti ng mga DPS. Dahil sa kanyang sinabi. So, okay. Pero yun, God has a reason either to will or to plan, to allow, permit things. Di ba ganun din naman tayo? O, bilang magula, marami sa inyo, magula, di ba? May mga bagay na gusto mo, pero may mga bagay na ayaw mo, ngunit inakayangan mo sa anak mo para matuto. Di ba? Para matuto. Kasi kahit na anong pangalan mo, hindi ka niya makihinggan. Anak, masakit pa ito. Hindi ka niya makihinggan kasi tingnan na mo yun. Kaya ako muna siya mabuto. Yan, sabi ko sa iyo, masakit. Yan na yun. Minsan may mga bagay na hahayaan mo maganap para sa ganun, eh, matuto magkaroon ng experience at wisdom in tao. So, okay. Maybe, this is the thing that happened. God allowed many things in the life of David. But you know, David was such a God-fearing person. Is the most important thing in David. Huh? He was such a God-fearing person. Na sa gitna ng lahat ng kanyang pagbansa, sa gitna ng kanyang lahat ng kapalpakan, he was always open to the will of God. And what happens? If you read Psalm 51, verse 12, brothers and sisters, You read Psalm 51, verse 12. You will hear there the beautiful prayer of David. Sabi niya, restore to me the joy of your salvation. And uphold me with a willing spirit. Again, the word restore. Ibalik mo ako, Panginoon, sa katuwaan ng iyong pagliligtas. At itaguyod mo ako na mayroong matatag na espiritu. Psalm 51 verse 12. So, restoration. Restoration, brothers and sisters, is actually a process that happens when we make things right again after things have gone wrong. To restore. You make things right again after things went wrong. You restore. Yeah, it has become a favorite term, one of the important terms in the computer. But the virus, it is restored. Diba? Yeah. Oh. So, restoration is making things right after they went wrong. This is one of my mandate now in my parish, making things right after they went wrong. So, to restore so that things will be well. Right? So, yon. Now, how does this happen? So, it happens, it is needed by persons. Persons need to be restored. It is needed by communities. Communities need to be restored. The church needs restoration. The physical church needs restoration. One time I had to celebrate Mass at San Sebastian Church. A nuptial mass. And when I came in, of course, I was very nostalgic because San Sebastian is one of my favorite churches. The only steel Gothic church of the Philippines, made of the same material as the Eiffel Tower of France. Kasi nga, they have placed, you know, many structures there, but they were all destroyed by fire or by earthquake. So finally, the Recoletos fathers decided to do something that neither fire nor earthquake can destroy. A steel church, shipped all the way from Belgium and France. So it's a landmark. Pero kung paso ko sa mga at dinin, e tapos nung nagbibisa ako, nuptial mas, umulan ko malakas, na ako ay nagpapatintero ng isang lugar o sa mga dulo. Oo. Kasi marami na hindi kinain na ng kalawang yung ibang part of the church. So the Recoletos Fathers, with that big challenge of restoring, to restore, to make things right. Now, how do we make things right? Unang-una po, napakahalaga na when we move towards restoration, the first thing that is very important is to be able to feel, first again of the love of God. So, in case of a spiritual restoration, yung nga sabi ni St. Paul to sa Galatians chapter 6, verse 10, sabi niya, brethren, if a man is overtaken by any sin, you who are spiritual must restore such a man in a spirit of gentleness. So, napakahalaga that we always begin a restoration with re-experiencing again that God loves us, that God loves me. Nagtataka ako rin, bumabalik ako dito sa SM Megamall. Pataas ng pataas yung mga glass panel sa tabi ng mga gumawa. Tapos sabi sa akin, paano mo, Father, yung iba tumatagol? E di patagol eh. Yung malang trip nila, yung trip lang ka. Parang masagal ng trip. Pero no, kidding aside,
you believe in God, you know, you
you know that you are always in the presence of God. You have never left the presence of God. And God, despite the fact na naman ang ginawa mo, God never condemns you. God never condemns you. Isaiah chapter 54, verse 9 to 10, has this beautiful text. In Isaiah 54, 9 to 10, sabi ko ng Panginoon, "So I have sworn that I will not be angry with you, nor rebuke you. For the mountains shall be barred, and the hills are removed, but my kindness shall not depart from you." My kindness shall not depart from you. What draws people to despair is not failure. We all have failures. Kung ang failure ang dahilan for us to despair, then we should all be desperate. But why is it that we all fail? We don't despair. Some become desperate. Ang kulang sa iba is yun. Sa gitna ng kanilang failure, they never feel the assuring love, the assuring love of God. Yan, napakalaga ko sa kita ng failure, dito man, na hindi mawawala yung experience na pagmamahal. No? Kasi pag yun nawala, then that is where the negatives come. Bishop, si Bishop Rodan from the Diocese of Ars. Ars is the place where St. John Marie Vianney was Spanish priest. Sabi ng Bishop ng Ars, Bishop Rodan, sabi niya, "Do not fear the virus, fear the epidemic of fear." Thank you. Katakan permanen tak itu apa ini? Tidak bisa ini. Diba?
Historia.
must know not only how to forgive oneself, but in a certain way, yes, also to forget what others have done. Se puede. There is a I encountered a beautiful verse from the Old Testament in the book of the prophet Joel. Joel is seldom discussed. One of the minor prophets of the Old Testament, Joel chapter 2, verse 25. Sabi dito ni Joel, I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten, the cankerworm and the caterpillar and the palmerworm, my great army which I sent among you. Sabi ng Panginoon, I will restore to you all the years that they have eaten. And I was just trying to, sabi ko, bakit ako puro worm ko binigay ito ni Lord? Yung pala, itong locust, itong canker worm, itong caterpillar, itong palmer worm, when they attack together, they attack together. One eats the leaves of the plant. Okay? The caterpillar eats the leaves. The branches are all eaten by the locust. The main stalk is eaten by the cankerworm. And the roots are all eaten by the palmer worm. Therefore, kapag yung apat na worm na yun yung umatak, ubus tayo. Ubus, as in, kahit na roots, wala. Pero nasabi ng Panginoon, I will restore to you the years that all these insects have eaten. So, you know, restoration becomes possible if indeed we would know how to let go of the past and begin anew. Begin anew, especially when it means forgiving others. Kung minsan ka din po ang nagiging malaking palagi sa atin, why we cannot experience this wonderful gift of restoration. We hang on to an unforgiveness of others. And alam niyo yung condition na binigay ng Panginoon eh. Sabi ng Panginoon sa Matthew 6:14, if you forgive men their transgressions, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. E paano ko hindi? Hindi nila. Yun ang condition. Alam niyo, this was the subject of a thesis. Bakit ganun si God? Bakit kailangan po na mag-forgive ako bago siya din mag-bigay? Akala ko ba yung forgiveness niya ay unconditional? How will you reconcile that? Parang yung sinasabi, God's forgiveness is unconditional. Diba? Eh bakit dito sa Matthew 6:14 na sabi naman niya, forgive men their transgressions, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. Wait na, tingin. Ba't gano'n? What is the meaning of this? Di ko mapunin. Simple lang po. The unconditional love of God, the unconditional forgiveness of God is given to all, especially those who have not really known the Lord while we were yet sinners. While we were yet sinners, the Lord has forgiven us. But Matthew 6:14, if you make a little location of the verse, you would see that Matthew 6:14 is part of the Sermon on the Mount. The Sermon on the Mount is directed as a teaching not to sinners, but to those who have already begun the way of discipleship. Kung sinner ka pa, wala ka pang alam, the Lord is unconditional. While we are yet sinners, Christ died for us. Pero when you begin your discipleship, you are already a disciple, and the Lord says, if you forgive others' transgression, then the Lord will also forgive you. In a certain way, the disciple now is something more. Tama. And because of that, iba na rin yung conviction ni God as a disciple. Tignan mo yung katabi mo. Ano ba yan? Disciple or disaster? Yun pala yun. Iba yung expected ni God sa baguhan. Iba yung expected ni God sa baguhan. Iba yung expected ni God sa isang matagal na sumusunod. Kasi siya mismo na sabi, to him who is given more, more is us. Oh, see? So, kaya ganun demanding si Lord kasi disciple ka rin. Pero kung disciple ka na, hindi mo pwede sabihin na, ay, basta hindi ako yung pupurgin. Anyway, pinoporgive naman ako ni Lord. Eh, sabi ni Lord, eh, iba na, disciple na rin. Oh, kung di ka mag-porgive, hindi na rin natin po-porgive. Ibang level ka na. Disciple ka na. So, if there is no unforgiveness, if there is unforgiveness in us, as a disciple, oh, ang gusto lang natin, we feel the love of God, but we don't like to share the love of God to others. Restoration, my dear brothers and sisters, cannot happen precisely because without forgiving others, unable to forgive others, we will always suffer from two important side effects of unforgiveness. Kaya hindi pwede magkaroon ng restoration. Ano yung dalawang side effects ng unforgiveness? Lalo-lalo na kung disciple ka na, you cannot forgive. Una is resentment. Hindi ka makapag-move on, hindi ka makapag-restore Kasi with your unwillingness to forgive, you have resentment. And you resent them. Or did I say to you the word? Resent. Oh. So, balik ng balik. Para email, di makarating. Bounce ng bounce. Hindi ka makakagyan ito. Nagpa-bounce eh. Oo. Dapat hanapan mo bakit ang blitz. So, that is the first side effect. Kung disciple na ako at unwilling ako, I cannot have restoration because I will always experience resentment. May nakita akong kamukha na hindi ko ma-forgive. Siya nga tayo. Masama ng feelings mo. No? Kaboses. Diba? Resentment. Bumabalik. But the other one, the other side effect of unwillingness to forgive is bitterness. Bitterness. That's the other really the other thing that happens when we are not able to forgive. Bitterness. So, what is very important when we would want to have the experience of restoration, which is a very timely experience in the season of Lent, then we have to be able to, as disciples, not only open ourselves to the forgiveness of God and allow God to love us, we have to lavishly also be able to give to others the gift of forgiveness. Yun yung ibig sabihin kung sinabi ng Lord kay Peter, Peter, not only 7 times, 70 times, 7 times. Matthew chapter 18, verse 22. So, not only 70 times, but 70 times 7 times. It has to be the lavish forgiveness. And when we are lavish with our forgiveness, you see, we experience joy and freedom. And restoration is always joy. Diba yung masabi ni David sa Psalm? Restore me to your joy, Lord. So, that is the sign that you are having restoration. Pumapalik yung joyfulness. Now, brothers and sisters, as we move towards restoration, okay, so I forgive myself, I allow God to embrace me, I also forgive others, and therefore leave behind, open up to the Lord, lahat yung mga bitterness and resentment na yan. Last thing is this. Is this impossible? The Lord Himself has given us the grace. Sabi nila, mula sa krus ni Jesus, sa Luke chapter 23, verse 34, you have the words of Jesus, Father, forgive them. Forgive them. they do not know what they do. Many people who begin to meditate on these words of Jesus on the cross say Jesus was not just talking about the people who crucified him, but they say Jesus was actually showing the secret of being able to forgive. And what is the secret of being able to forgive? To always find an excuse for others. Forgive them. For they do not know what they are doing. The grace of forgiveness happens when we keep those words of the Lord in mind. We try to justify others by allowing the grace of God to cover what they have done. So, siguro, brothers and sisters, napakasimple mo ng malaking points na itong ating topic ngayon today. To speak about restoration through forgiveness. But that is really one of the beautiful things that can happen to us in our life. You can only have joy if there is restoration. The only difference, let me end with this, the difference between reconciliation and restoration is very subtle. Reconciliation is also a process. It also begins with forgiveness. It also is established with forgiveness. Pero ang concern ng reconciliation is only the re-establishment of interpersonal relationship. How do I know that there is reconciliation? If I am able to establish an interpersonal relationship, pagkatapos ng lahat na naganap, na ibalik ko yung relationship natin. May mga relationship hindi na naipapalik. You forgive and that's it. Kalimutan na tayo, patawaran tayo, pero kalimutan na. But reconciliation is if you are able to forgive and re-establish relationship. However, you may be able to re-establish relationship, but there is no joy yet. There is no joy yet. Joy happens when you move from reconciliation to restoration. That is where the joy is also recovered. So, siguro, as we move through the season of Lent, we have to be able to see this. Lord, challenge ka ni Lord sa atin, hindi na forgive, hindi na reconcile, hindi to learn how to restore. Buti pa yung computer na restore. Yung iba, hindi. Amen.
Restore. One Ang dami pa rin umaten. Diba? Kahit ganun ang sitwasyon, diba? Dami pa rin umaten sa akin. Thank you, Lord. Salamat po.